So welcome to another TMC 4GWE telecast. I'm here with my pal Paul Engels, who is the EVP CMO of Hostopia.
There you are. Thanks, Carl.
So let's get through it. I was thinking of Hostopia earlier, and I was saying to myself, my God, I think I've seen them since the beginning of ISPCon, and we're here at Supercom now. So obviously the world's kind of changed from the ISP's play to the carrier, to the bigger carriers. So how do you guys play with this?
Well, Carl, there have been huge changes in the industry. As you know, the consolidation in the service provider marketplace, little players have been gobbled up by bigger players, and Hostopia has moved along with that ride. Our franchise was built on small, medium-sized service provider enterprises, a few of the larger players. That's moved now pretty much to tier one, tier two broadband providers. That's our marketplace.
And you're global now in nature, right? Tell me where your centers are.
We got started with most of our sales in Canada and the U.S. At the time, when we founded a little after 99, it was about 50-50. Now we're well diversified. We have clients like BT, Carphone Warehouse, Colt Communications in Europe, largely out of London area. We're expanding through EMEA, and we've got a lot of activity going on in Central and South America. So we're pretty much truly a global company.
Okay. And for the benefit of people who don't know, let's talk about primarily your white label services for messaging and web hosting. Would that be an accurate portrayal, or is there other services
That's
as well?
That's absolutely our core franchise, but that category has been expanding as well. So the word host in our name certainly denotes hosting, but it's really now more about hosted applications, not just web hosting. Web hosting is pretty commoditized, so the franchise has expanded. It's pretty much any application that serves over the web that helps a small business, sweet spot being 2 to 20 employees, improve their revenues and sales on the internet. E-commerce, search engine marketing, email marketing, communications apps like fax to email, and business class email, as we discussed.
Okay, and just out of curiosity, you guys have been around for the changes from the modem pools to the broadband side. So now what's going on with mobile? How is mobile broadband happening to you? What do you see?
Well, the first transition that you talked about, modem pools to broadband, has been huge. It's really the ubiquity of broadband that's driving the usage of applications like ours. Small businesses now pretty much can do anything they want through a secure connection and a browser. Broadband has enabled that. We pay a lot of attention to a consultant by the name of John Warlow, and he says, besides creating more revenue, the next thing that motivates small business is freedom and mobility. The guy driving a truck for a service business, his office is where he is. So mobile is huge. And we're very active in that space with, as I mentioned to you prior to the interview, our Nexthouse acquisition. This is a technology based on SyncML that allows a small business to fundamentally keep all of his contacts, diary entries, agenda, calendars, and notes, his email, fully synchronized between his desk and his smartphone. Very productive, very useful.
Cool. Now, if people want to find Hostopia, how would they do that?
Because we're a pure play hosting provider, really the web is the place to find us. Our site, hostopia.com, has pretty much everything a person needs to get acquainted. But, you know, it's not the end user, recall, that we market to. Our applications are built for end users, but they only sell through our wholesale distribution of service providers.
Okay. And typically, is there any activity going on with rural carriers and the smaller guys?
Indeed, there is. We've got an aggressive sales effort with the rural carriers, and we have clients in that space, and we've also got some exciting conversations. Wherever small businesses reside, that's where Hostopia needs to be. And, you know, it's not a question you've asked specifically, but what excites us about 2010, there's kind of, I don't want to exaggerate and call it a nuclear winter, but let's face it, core services to a broadband company, voice and data, it's a tough slog right now. Revenues are challenged, landlines are being lost. We're the guys that fill in the value-added services that top up that revenue again, and what I call anchor the tenant, keep the client loyal to the broadband provider. You can switch broadband at the turn of a dial, but when you're populated with domain-based services, web hosting, e-commerce, you are basically running your business through the internet, that's a very hard thing to switch. So that's kind of what we try to do for our customers.
Got it. Great. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Appreciate it, Carl. Thank you.